George Gershwin was born on September 26, 1898, in Brooklyn, New York. Today, he is known as one of America's most beloved popular musicians. The aspiring composer started his career as a song plugger on Tin Pan Alley. At 17, he had his first song published, and at 20, he was a composer of Lala Lucille, his first Broadway show, and also his first big song hit, Swanee.
My parents had in mind that I, as the oldest child, was shortly to start taking lessons. But the upright had scarcely been put into place when George, he was then 11 or 12, twirled the stool down to size, sat, lifted the keyboard cover, and played an accomplished version of a then popular song. Naturally, we were all startled at this hitherto undisclosed talent of his. How? When? We wanted to know. He made it sound very simple. Whenever he had the chance, he'd been fooling around and experimenting on a player piano at the home of a schoolmate around the corner.
Ira may not have been as musical as his parents had hoped, but instead, he wrote the lyrics for many of Gershwin's pieces. George's most famous composition was Rhapsody in Blue, a one-movement work for piano and orchestra. He wrote this jazz-inspired piece when he was only 25, an incredible composition for such a young man. He wrote most of this composition on February 4th, but did not finish the last piano piece until filling in the blanks during the first performance. His second most popular piece, An American in Paris, uses authentic taxi horns as well as other clever musical devices. George Gershwin had an incredible life, as well as many well-known compositions. Sadly, during his last year of making music, Gershwin became more and more sick. On July 9, 1937, he collapsed into a coma due to a large brain tumor. He passed away only 2 days later. He made plans to compose a string quartet, a ballet, and another opera, but these pieces were never able to be written.